Hey everyone, I'm that funky guy, and you know what I love more than anything? Cartoons!
What can I say? Growing up in the 80s and 90s, my life seemed to be surrounded by two things, video games and cartoons, and I especially loved watching TV animation.
I know what some of you hardcore animation fans are gonna say. TV animation? Theatrical animation is so much better! Why would anyone like TV animation? And I'd simply say, shut the fuck up!
Yeah, most theatrical animation tends to have better quality and writing than most TV animation, but that's the thing that makes TV animation more interesting to me. While TV animation may not look as nice as an animated movie or a theatrical short, TV animation was also made with a fraction of the budget, time, and staff that a theatrical movie is made with. And they made a whole series with these shortcomings rather than just one 90-minute movie or one 10-minute short film. So to me, it's interesting to see what people can do when they have so little. Not to mention the fun of waking up on Saturday mornings with a big bowl of cereal just to see what adventures your favorite animated characters were getting into. This all contributed to my enjoyment and love for TV animation. Having such limitations caused some people to get creative and make amazing productions, while other people got cheap, lazy, and half-assed.
So grab your favorite sugary cereal and your favorite flavored vodka, because we're going to watch one of the worst things that come out of the animation fun bag. Be afraid, peeps. Be very afraid. We're going to watch the Battletoads cartoon.
Ah, Battletoads. If you ever played this game on the NES, you'll most likely remember it for one thing. Being fucking hard.
No, I mean really, really fucking hard. I mean so fucking hard that you punch a nun out of sheer frustration. I mean, this is beyond Nintendo hard. This is punch yourself. Ow. Anyways, what better way to honor it than make a show that's as hard to watch as Battletoads is to play? I present to you all the Battletoads cartoon pilot.
Yes, you heard me. Pilot. This was the only episode of the Battletoads cartoon, and it aired on Thanksgiving of 1992 in an attempt to gain enough interest to make a full-fledged series.
And seeing as it didn't get picked up for a series, I think it's safe to say that no one was thankful that it aired. God knows I wasn't. But hey, I've got a review to do, so let's check out the show's intro.
Really? A surfer theme? Because, you know, muscular toads wearing leather really seem to be the surfing type. Don't you think some heavy metal would have gone better with them? You know, some Slayer, Metallica.
Wild Stallions!
David Wise? I know that name. He was the head writer of the 80s Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle cartoon. Well, what better way to rip off the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles than to steal their head writer?
Good, I guess that makes for a short show then.
No, it's not that easy. This is Professor T-Bird and Princess Angelica, and they are trying to escape the big bad of the series, who seems to be after the princess's amulet, for some reason. Who's the big bad, you ask? Well, it's Jessica Rabbit's evil sister, simply known as the Dark Queen. How original. I guess that's the best they could do since, you know, Lady Death was already taken. Her superpowers include turning into a tornado and chewing the scenery. Especially the second one. She'd probably be hot if she didn't have that giant forehead that puts the Undertakers to shame.
No.
And just so you anime fans know, T-Bird is voiced by Michael Donovan, probably best known for his role as Ryoga in the Ranma 1/2 dub, and Colonel Guile in the Street Fighter cartoon.
Get away. Her royal guard is wiped out. Her only friend in the entire universe is that crackpot Professor T-Bird. Who could possibly save her now?
Yeah, good thing her spaceship didn't have any sensors or scanners or anything to see you hiding behind that asteroid like a Tom and Jerry cartoon.
Morgan Ziegler, Dave Shar, George Pye.
Wait. Did they just say the fat guy's last name was Pie?
George Pie.
He said the fat guy's last name was Pie? That's so wrong. so wrong I probably shouldn't be laughing at it, but I will anyways.
Seemingly, the principal is telling these three dorks that they are the biggest losers on the face of the earth, and it's because they're such a bad influence on each other and that they should no longer hang out together. Man, I'll give Mr. Weatherby here some credit. If the biggest problem his school is having is three loser kids, then he's doing a pretty good job of running the place. Though I could point out he has no rights determining who they have as friends, but oh well. Curse that Archie Andrews! So we get to see the kids fail at being sociable, and fail miserably, I might add. I'm not the most social person in the world, peeps, but these guys take it over 9,000!
What 9,000?!
By accidentally destroying a basketball and hoop, somehow, drawing a Metallica cover for a homecoming poster, and blowing up a computer! And yes, I threw in an overused Dragon Ball Z reference. Deal with it.
Gosh, I love how in pre-2K cartoons, no one seems to realize how computers work. I mean, there's nothing he can do that would warrant that. It's not like he can type explode.exe and make the whole thing go boom.
Oh, I knew I shouldn't have gotten a Dell. So back to Buzz Buzzard and Princess Toadstool, they've come to some temple building cave something to get the
genetic essence of the Battletoads!
The what?
The genetic essence of the Battletoads!
The genetic essence of the Battletoads? Why would you have... Why would it be in a temple? Is it a sperm clinic? I don't want to know. I just don't want to know. But T-Bird says that they can use it to create some new Battletoads. Sure, whatever you want to give me, show. Anyways, the Dark Queen arrives shooting her pew-pews at our heroes, and T-Bird pulls out a ballpoint pen that turns into a golf club and allows them to teleport to Earth. Why they didn't just use a teleporter to get away from the Dark Queen and get the Battletoad spooge, I don't know. Probably because David Wise hadn't written himself into a corner yet. Eek! Creepy spike placement there, guy! So the nerds are playing video games at the local 7-Eleven. I miss those days. When T-Hawk and Princess Daisy pop out of the video game machine, since T-Bird's prescription is obviously out of date, he mistakes the nerds shut up, Ogre. Four heroes and splatters them with the Battletoad spooge, turning them into the title characters of the show. I don't know how that works, nor do I want to know. The geeks, aren't too thrilled with being turned into toads, but I hate to tell them something.
It's an improvement.
I mean, before no girl would take any remote interest in them, now they can at least turn the heads of some furries, even if they don't have fur. So, Miss Death Star and her lackeys come out of the Slurpee machine and grabs the princess and starts playing her like a guitar?
That's right! My guitar's in my mind! Leave it to me!
The Battletoads go to save the princess and... What does that poster say?
Give me a zoom up of that poster in the background.
Thanks for making the jokes for me, show. Well, one of the toads grabs an ice cream freezer and throws it at the baddies, only for it to fall on Princess Angelica? What? Fail! No, Angelica's okay. Somehow. As she pops out of the freezer eating a fudgesicle. Okay, whatever you want to give me. After a pathetic fight scene, and I do mean pathetic, the Dark Queen escapes, threatening the return. After holding her ice cream bar in her mouth in a sort of phallic manner,
which is kinda hot. Sorry.
Angelica names the toads Zits, Rash, and Pimple, which they oddly like. I'd say something here, but I think AVGN has said it best.
The intro shows three toads, Rash, Pimple, and Zits. Why such disgusting names? How about herpes, genital warts, and gonorrhea?
Hey, I can't top that, so why try?
Anyways, T-Bird informs the toads that they can turn into their normal selves whenever they want, and the toads in turn give us some catchphrases that will never catch on.
Psychotronic!
Incredible!
Cosmorific!
Let's get normal!
Might as well have them say Calabunga while you're at it.
cowabunga, dude!
Yeah, like that!
Gosh!
Anyways, the geeks find T-Bird and Princess Zelda a place to live, give them some random junk, and a broken-down pink car.
Working or not, I'm sure that car costs a lot more money than those stupid kids had. But hey, it's a T-Bird, I guess. It goes with the professor, I guess.
And lastly, the nerds.
Nerds!
Informs T-Bird that they were rejected from their audition to be in the Big Bang Theory, and they need to get a job in order to make money. Since Princess What's-Her-Name looks like a human, this is dropped on her, and she gets a job as a... porn star? Well, no, but you could fool me. She's supposedly working for a donut store, but hell if I could tell with that get-up.
Hey, watch it with the jelly donuts!
Forgive me. I am new to Oxnard and know little of these... jelly donut.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Don't look at me like that. You knew that line was going to show up eventually.
So the bad guys somehow find out where T-Bird is living and attack the toads.
All right. It's time to pop a zit and squeeze a pimple and scratch a rash.
I'd make a comment about how that line is more disgusting than it is threatening, but I'm still trying to figure out how he knew their names.
We have another badly animated fight scene where Rash gives us one of the goofiest run cycles I've ever seen.
Full metal earmuffs! Kiss my fist!
You know, heroes or not, I just can't take the toads seriously with those terrible voices. You'd think that turning into muscle-bound frogs would deepen their voices, or something. Anything but this.
Okay, think with my hands. Think with my hands.
Wow, what a weird time to hit puberty. But it seems the whole thing was a distraction so the Dark Queen could capture the princess. Hey, she's a video game princess. Being kidnapped is part of her job description. But all is not lost, as T-Bird informs the Toads that he has modified the car into a spaceship. With magic!
Going, we don't need
tigers. Really? If you're gonna rip off dialogue from Back to the Future, you honestly should have just said the actual line. Sadly, that would have been funnier. Anyways, they fly to another castle, planet, that the Dark Queen is holding Princess Leia at. T-Bird mentions the building as a generator of some sorts, where the Dark Queen gets all of her power. How convenient. The Toads reenact a scene from the video game while the Dark Queen threatens Princess Peach.
Even your amulet's magic cannot protect you from it. I suggest you give it to me willingly.
Really? You're gonna shoot her if she doesn't give it to you willingly? You've got her arms locked up. She can't give it to you at all. Not to mention you can just take it off her anyways. What the fuck, Sho?
So the Toads get to the Dark Queen. She turns into a tornado. I'm serious, I can't make this stuff up. We get another stupid fight scene and the Toads destroy the Dark Queen's generator.
No!
So the Toads escape the destruction and we get this scene of the Dark Queen.
I don't believe it! My generator is gone! I'm powerless!
I hate to say this, but maybe keeping captives in your only source of power wasn't exactly the greatest idea. Just maybe.
And then she mounts the bull guy.
Ew, furry, ew!
So you think the show's over? God, I wish, but no, we got more crap to swallow. The Geek Squad is seen hanging out together, and the principal tells them they're suspended. The Geeks say he can't do that because they're intergalactic heroes, and turns into the Battletoads right in front of them.
They aren't insane, they're evil freaks!
But before the principal can call the authorities, the Dark Queen attacks in a giant flying razor blade? So the Dark Queen threatens to destroy the mall. Yeah, the mall.
Don't let her destroy our mall!
So the Toads get into the razor blade, the Dark Queen tells them it's a trap, and they're surrounded by baddies with laser-firing satellite dishes pointed right at them. So the Toads escape by jumping out of the way.
Really?
And the laser blast missed the Toad, shooting the razor blade ship, destroying it.
Again, really?
Seriously, That's what happens. It doesn't make sense. Unless the ship was made out of tinfoil or aluminum, it should be able to take a laser blast. Especially since it's a space traveling vessel, and it's not like the lasers hit any control panels or computers on the ship, because the animators didn't bother to draw anything in the backgrounds at all. So it looked more like a cargo bay and less like a control room. This is just stupid, lazy nonsense. I mean, seriously, what the hell?
That doesn't even make any sense.
So everyone escapes, Mr. Weatherby is cool with the Toads hanging out with each other, Princess Toadstool hugs the Toads, and we're told that this is just the beginning. Fortunately, it's a lie, and it's actually the ending.
So that was Battletoads. What's the verdict? Well, let's do the Funky Guy overview and find out.
The goods? Well, the best character in the entire show was that clerk at the 7-Eleven. It was like he had no interest in what was going on, and I felt like I could relate to him. Other than that, some of the Dark Queen's insane overacting is amusing. And the scene where Princess Angelica holds a popsicle in her mouth is amusingly erotic for a kid's show.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Anyways, that's about it.
The bads? Everything else. The animation is atrocious, the character designs are miserable, and the backgrounds look like they were drawn by a grade schooler. The characters were either uninteresting or obnoxious, and I hated the voices given to the characters. And hell, even the theme song inflicts pain on me.
In short, Battletoads was a horrible, abysmal show that didn't get past the pilot. And trust me, that's a good thing. I mean, there's no reason to watch it at all. It doesn't even have so bad it's good qualities. It's just bad. So bad that I'm gonna play the video game to clear my palate. See ya.